Hi friends, I'm Yin Arenas, Program Manager on the Microsoft Graph team. Today, I'll share a brief overview about what is Microsoft Graph and why is it important for you, what are the new features that we released during Build 2018, and how you can get started with Microsoft Graph in your own applications. So, what is Microsoft Graph? Microsoft Graph is all about you. If you or your customers are part of the millions of users that are using Microsoft Cloud services, then Microsoft Graph is the fabric to all of your data. There are over 120 million monthly active commercial users, over 180 countries that have data in Microsoft Graph. Just over the past year, usage of the Microsoft Graph has increased over 800%, and we have over 27,000 applications making a collective 8 billion API calls to Microsoft Graph. So as a developer, it means that you can use Microsoft Graph to tap into Microsoft 365 services and experiences and use them in your own applications. Microsoft Graph gives you a unified REST API and a comprehensive developer experience for integrating with data and intelligence exposed by these services. Do you need to inject collaboration in your app? Well, connect it to Microsoft Teams. Do you need file and content management? Then connect it to SharePoint. Or if you need email and calendar integration, you can connect it to Outlook. For identity management, we have Azure AD. For device management, you can connect to Intune. All of these services and much more are available to you in the Microsoft Graph through a single REST API endpoint, graph.microsoft.com. And to top it off, this all works whether you are building an application for work or school or personal use through a single authentication flow. So Microsoft Graph gives you access to tons of data, relationships, and insights. And we're constantly growing those data sets by adding new Microsoft Cloud services. This year, at Build 2018, we announced lots of new APIs and features, more than I can actually fit on a slide. To get a full view of all the new releases, check our blog and the new changelog in our website. It's actually not new, but it's still there. Also, check all the videos in this series that have the latest news for each of the APIs. Here, I'm going to highlight just a few. First, I'm going to start with the Project Roam activity APIs from Windows. We announced the general availability of these APIs in the Microsoft Graph. These APIs enable you to drive user engagement with your apps across devices and platforms. Each activity shows up in the Windows timeline and has a deep link, a rich visualization using adaptive cards, and content metadata describing the activity. Next, we have the security APIs. We announced the preview of the security APIs in Microsoft Graph. This provides a standard interface and common schema for integrating security solutions for Microsoft and partners. You can access or act on security insights from multiple sources, and partners can contribute security alerts and expose security actions through the graph. Then we have webhooks for users and groups, which are now also available. Do you want to get notified every time a new member is added to a group to trigger a workflow? Then with this new functionality, we're making it super easy to get push notifications for important changes to data in the graph. Then we have updated Outlook APIs. We've added a ton of features for this release, like working hours, message rules, categories, time zones, headers, and much more, helping you easy integrate email and calendar functionality in your app for users that collaborate across the globe. One of my favorites is the new Open API descriptions for the Microsoft Graph. You might know this from their previous name, Swagger, which is a widely adopted REST API description and documentation format. Well, Swagger descriptions have a new name, which is OpenAPI. The current version is V3, and we're making OpenAPI descriptions available for all Microsoft Graph. Today, you'll find them on our GitHub repo, and pretty soon we'll make them available as part of the API endpoint. Then, coming soon, I'm really happy that we announced two services that will be joining the Microsoft Graph family. The first one is the spatial analytics services to get data from IoT and devices in your organization. And then the other one is user notifications that is a service that you can use for storing and forwarding notifications across devices on a per app and a per user basis. To find information about all of these features and more, and to get started with all of these features, just go to dev.microsoft.com/graph. That's where our developer portal is. And right now, let's see a demo of Microsoft Graph in action. The first step on our demo, I actually wanted to show you our developer portal. It's hosted on dev.microsoft.com/graph, and it has all of the information that you need to get started with developing with Microsoft Graph. I'm going to point you to two locations in this portal. The first one is going to be our quick starts. So if you want to get an application up and running in less than 3 minutes in all of these different platforms that you have here, then you can come to the quick starts, follow the workflow that we have in place, and get an app, download an app that you will be able to just F5 and run. Pretty simple. The second place that I wanted to point you out is to our Graph Explorer. Graph Explorer is a very, very cool tool that allows you to make requests to the API, whether or not you have an account. So right now, I'm not logged in using my account, and I can run sample queries to the graph. There's also a set of samples that we have prepackaged here. We have a set of getting started queries, and then we have more samples that you can turn on and off about the service that you want to integrate with. It will show you sample queries, and it will give you pointers to the documentation that we have for each of the APIs. And finally, our documentation, where you will find all of the information about the API reference and all of the different things that you want that you can do with the Microsoft Graph API. Now let's take a look at a demo using the Microsoft Graph and connecting to the bot framework. In this demo, we're going to be showing a bot that is connecting to the Microsoft Graph to take files that are sitting in OneDrive and then create an actionable message to send it over Outlook using adaptive cards. So let's get started with the bot. First, we're going to say hi. And get approval is what this bot is trained to do. This particular bot, so we've already logged in. So it's going to go straight to make a graph.microsoft.com request. In this case, we're using the client library, and we're making a request to OneDrive to bring all of the files that are sitting in the root. We're going to continue. And it's going to show me the list of all of the files that found in OneDrive. I'm going to click on one of the files. And the next request that it's going to make is going to be to bring in the information for the file. In this particular one, it's bringing the thumbnail. Turns out that OneDrive supports that you get thumbnails for all of the different files that are hosted in OneDrive. And there are actually 200 file formats that are supported. What you get back is a URL, and from that URL, you can create your own byte64 encoded version of the file, of the image of the file. So I'm going to continue here. And the next thing that we're going to see is all of the information about this file, metadata from the file, and the thumbnail that was created from the thumbnail URL. Next, we're going to tell the bot that this is the file that we're selecting. So we're going to click yes over here. We're going to continue over here. And it's asking me, who should I send this for approval? So we're going to click and type in the email. Then we're going to send the request. And what the bot is going to do is going to create the payload that is going to be using to send over the email. First, it's going to bring the picture of the user that is making the request. Then it's going to bring in the additional information of the file, actually converting that into that base64 encoded image. And then it's going to send the email with that actionable message into the into the person's inbox. So let's check that out. I think I have this window over here with this account. And let's go to Outlook. And what we're going to see is an email that has that actionable message that was sent from the bot asking for an approval on that particular file. Should have seen the email, and the email is not there. Let's click on send the request again, and of course, continue on my breakpoint, and go back to refresh the inbox. And here's the email. So when we look at this email, we're going to see an actionable message and we're using adaptive cards. It's right here. We have a little bug on OWA that hopefully will be fixed by the time that you're looking this video, watching this video. And then I can go ahead and approve this workflow right here within the context of my inbox. If we look at this card and actually go and look at how it looks on the visualizer on adaptivecards.io, you will see that this is a very common, you know, like the visualization that we get for Outlook actionable messages is just JSON format that it's very easy to author and, you know, play around with. Okay, let's go back to our bot and our code. And I think that, you know, that sums up what I wanted to show for this demo, which is a bot that is using the Microsoft Graph to integrate with OneDrive, bringing thumbnails from OneDrive files, and then creating actionable messages using adaptive cards to send an email from Outlook. So to recap, Microsoft Graph is the gateway to your data in the Microsoft Cloud. As a developer, you can build applications that connect to your customers in Office 365, Windows, and EMS using Microsoft Graph, giving you access to their identity, rich content, deep insights, and real-time updates. And of course, following strict privacy, security, and access control policies. You can get started today, right away, visit our developer portal, ask questions in Stack Overflow, or check our samples in GitHub. We actually have a space where the community is contributing more and more samples every day. And we'd love to hear from you on Twitter as well. Thank you for taking the time to learn about the Microsoft Graph with me today, and happy coding.